There is no reason why we can't work together, Democrats and Republicans, to pass these initiatives. But if you're skeptical about the prospects for bipartisanship in the wake of what we've seen our politics become recently, well, I can't say that I blame you. So I want to close by saying this. I think it's incumbent on every public official, no matter what party you belong to or how much responsibility you bear for the events of last month, to look for ways to fix our broken politics. After all, as my conversation with my conservative colleague demonstrated, we all come here with the same goal in mind, helping the people we represent build the lives they want for their families. But while a lot of the anger and division in our politics comes from overheated rhetoric and selfish partisanship, I think there's something else going on here too. The people who sent us here are frustrated. They keep telling us what they need. They need good schools. They need safe roads. They need more opportunities to advance their careers, start businesses, and build economic security. And then we come to Harrisburg and all we do is nibble around the edges of these problems. A little more funding here, a new pilot program there. We do what the politics of the moment allows, and we promise to try again next year. But if you're one of those Pennsylvanians starting out, one of those young families surrounded by all those imposing barriers, well, that's just not good enough. You know, you only get to go through life once, and every year we don't act to solve these problems, well, that's a year you can never get back. It's another year where it feels like you're only working all those hours so you can write those checks to your landlord or your health insurance company. It's another year where you pay your taxes right on time, but there never seems to be enough money in the state's budget to fix that pothole on your way to work. It's another year where your kids get taller, your local schools, they don't get better, and college doesn't get any more affordable. No wonder people get frustrated. It's no wonder they get angry. No wonder people start to feel like nobody in government cares. It's no wonder they start looking to politicians who promise to shake everything up. So let's stop with the excuses. Let's move beyond the chronic timidity. Let's do something. Let's lift those barriers and let's stop making excuses for why we can't.